and welcome to the tutorial on Excel Solver. This video will talk about Sumproduct, which is an essential function while solving LPs on Excel. So grab a mug of coffee and let us get started. Before I begin, I want to let you know that the Excel file I will be using in this video is available on my webpage. I will leave the link in the description below. This video aims to set up an objective function equation manually, and then show how you can do it with fewer steps using the SumProduct function. Consider the objective function maximize z equals 4x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus 7x4. Pretend that x1, x2, x3, and x4 are 8, 7, 0, and 5, respectively. Let's start filling the two tables. On the light gray cells, type the values of the decision variables, which are 8, 7, 0, and 5. Then, on the light green cells, type the coefficients of the objective function, 4, 1, 1, and 7. Let's start with the manual setup. In row 8, let's write the multiplication between the decision variables and the coefficients. Thus, on cell B8, type equal B6 star B7. On cell C8, type equal C6 star C7. On cell D8, type equal D6 star D7. And in cell E8, type E6 star E7. Now that we have performed the multiplications, we can add these cells. In cell B9, type equal sum parentheses and select the arrow B8 to E8, the dark green cells. Close parentheses and press Enter. Awesome! We got an objective function value of 74. Let's use the SumProduct function now. Go to cell B15, type equal SumProduct parentheses, then select the light gray cells B13 up to E13. Press comma and select the light green cells B14 up to E14. Close parentheses and press Enter. Great, we got 74 as well, and we performed the same calculation with fewer steps. I have two observations with respect to SumProduct. First, the order of the arrays is not important. Either way will work. Second, sometimes people get an error while separating the arrays with a comma. In this case, try to use a semicolon. I hope you understood how the SumProduct function works. This will be extremely useful to our next steps. That's it for this video. Stay tuned to the upcoming tutorials.